Oh, good one.
Gonna get high, man. I ain't had enough. Need me a triple shot of that.
This is for you, Jim.
One beer.
We're hanging with Jim Jeffries today. Opie and Anthony. We got Jason Ellis. He's going to be in studio in just a minute or two here. I don't know. Jason Ellis and Jim Jeffries went at it on the phone or something, right?
First time
you're going to meet him live.
Yeah, I'm not.
You're both
nervous.
From the same place originally, right?
Probably, yes.
So yeah,
I'm sure.
I think
we'll
in the end you guys will be just
be good
fine.
For common ground. Because he's a funny guy. I'm an excellent skateboarder. Not many people know that about me.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, I didn't know it either. But I just think that I could do it.
Yeah,
I don't come off as the type.
Yeah, yeah.
If I said I was good at any sport, would you go, really? That seems about
No.
Let me think of what sport maybe. Like bowling.
Yeah, I look like a guy who
you look like a bowler.
Yeah.
You know.
Are you good at bowling?
No, I'm terrible at it.
Yeah.
Actually, yeah.
Yeah.
But you think because of the shaky hands, you think a big heavy ball, that would be a go-to sport for me?
Yeah. Yeah, all you got to do is heave it down the fucking lane, drink some beer,
yeah,
hang out.
Kingpin bowling is the weird thing that I think that's the only sport in the world that every single country has gone, nah, we like that. Every other sport is like every other country has its own little separate things, but everyone universally has gone, and we all like it the same amount. Everyone's like, yeah, we like 10-pin bowling a bit.
Yeah. Like candlestick bowling.
Yeah, it's not like it doesn't run away with a country where it's like, oh wow, that's the national sport of this country or whatever. But everyone likes going. It's fun.
So we should have the World Cup in bowling. Fuck that soccer thing.
The whole
world could get involved with a bowling tournament.
I took my nephew and my niece bowling the other day, and kids now are shit at it because, you know, because the bumper bowling.
Bumper bowling.
Putting the bumper bowling. When I was a kid, you just got gutter ball after gutter ball, and you fucking manned up about the whole thing.
You had to figure out how to not fucking get it in the gutter.
And you went back with a score of 27.
Yeah.
And you were like, all right, that was better than last week. It was 18. I'm getting better. Then you'd fluke one thing. So my nephew now has reached 11, and my niece is 9. And so I said, when I was out in Australia, I said, okay, she can still have the gutters, but you're too fucking old. You can't have them. And then he realized he used to get these top scores, and then he figured out he was shit at it. Right?
Yeah.
And so he starts crying because his sister's beating him in a game. And I go, you're 11, you stop fucking crying. So that was his outing with his uncle. Just learning that he's shit at sport and being told to man up.
They used to drag those literal bumpers. They had like the big fucking
tubes
that they put in the gutter. And now it's just these electronic fucking
that come up for their turn. Come up.
And yeah, sometimes they come up for, you know, you could program it in so it comes up for little Jimmy or something like that.
You should only be allowed to have the bumpers if you're under 5 or you're Down syndrome. Or
in a wheelchair, maybe?
A quad.
Or
if you're a quad,
all right.
If you're a quad with a ramp and a pointing hat. Like to push the ball off the ramp.
I'm not into that fucking little wheelchair person, little aiming device, and they put the bowling ball on top of it and roll it down.
You're not into that?
It's not bowling.
Yeah,
let me use that fucking thing. I'll be able to put it in one spot, know exactly where it is for a strike every fucking time. Yeah,
but you're not a retard.
some people would argue that point.
I think Down syndrome people, because they got the superhuman strength. See, I used to... No, they do. They're superhuman. See, this is the whole thing about Down syndrome people, right? Everyone thinks that they have a bad life, but in my experience with working with disabled people, Down syndrome people, happiest people on earth.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But always hugging and happy. Mm-hmm. Amazing sexual energy to them as well. But it's because the guys have big cocks and they're really strong. And quintessentially, that's all you want in life.
To be strong and have a big cock.
That would make you happy.
Yeah. So that's why they're happy.
Yeah. I got a big cock and I can lift heavy things. So, have you gone quiet? Are you?
You're
not going to tell me that your brother's Down syndrome or something like that.
So Sam was giving me something I had to check out for a second.
Is impeccable.
Impeccable.
Your logic is impeccable.
This logic has to be in a book.
It's fantastic.
It's very good.
Well, they're measured arguments.
Well, why don't we move on? Because Jason Ellis is hanging outside the studio.
Yes.
Yeah. Sam has got a little update because there's problems outside the studio already.
Yeah. During the break, I was in the producer studio discussing show strategies with Troy and Travis.
Oh, wow.
Sure you were.
At which point, Liam, our talent booker, who is with our guest, mm-hmm. who you would think would be treated respectfully before he came on the show, yeah. let me know that blind intern Stevie had somehow...
Speaking of Down syndrome.
Yes.
People are confused. They're seeing the latest video. He does not have Down syndrome.
No, I thought he might have when...
You think he might have a little of the Downs,
see, this,
right?
See, this is the whole thing. He's got the look, he's got the physique, but he doesn't have the charm or happiness.
Probably the big cock of the super.
And you nailed what he looks like, by the way, Jim Jefferies.
He looks like the little boy out of the Far Side calendar.
Yes, he does. Yeah. So what is Stevie doing?
Well, I left him in the office, and he, for some reason, on his own accord, for once, I didn't even instigate this. Mm. On his own accord, he waddled up the hallway and started fighting with Jason Ellis.
About what? Like, what's his beef?
Bring him in.
He fought with him yesterday. He's making fun of his accent. He called him a princess.
Why didn't he make fun of my accent? Why?
He said, after you left the room, you said you were a self-hating Australian earlier. Yeah. After you left the room, Stevie goes, now that's a good Australian.
Fuck this little Down syndrome.
Now you're mad at him, too. Get him in here.
Fucking.
You want to bring Jason in, too, or you want to talk to Stevie first?
Bring in the Far Side.
Bring in Stevie for a sec. He has the worst eyes without not being blind.
Yeah.
This is it.
So, okay.
Stevie, what's going on with you?
I don't know what's going on with you guys.
No, stop it.
You know what you just did there? Friends go, where have you been all night? I don't know. Where have you been all night? You're in trouble.
What's your problem with
Jason Ellis?
Jason Ellis and Australians.
Why don't you like the guy outside? Okay, here's what happened.
The guy outside.
Okay.
The train killer, yes.
I was introduced to him yesterday, and I was trying to have a casual conversation with him because I don't really know the guy at all. So I figured...
Mistake number one, by the way. You're a fucking intern. You're not supposed to be having casual conversations
Sam
with the guests.
Sam introduced me. Sam kind of forced my hand a little bit. He's like, here, why don't you meet
all right. Just blame Sam. By the way, passing the buck. Good strategy.
This is the same thing that happened with the morning mashup. For some reason, he's the one intern. When I introduce him to people that might help him somehow, like other interns would be like, oh, cool, you introduced me.
Yeah.
He's saying, yes, Sam forced me to meet this guy.
Oh, I didn't
you never know if he's looking for like a half a retard or something. You're perfect for the job.
Look at your fucking... Oh, look at your Larry Sanders lips. Doesn't he have Larry Sanders lips?
You do have Larry Sanders lips. Yeah.
I can't help how
And Ricky Lake's body.
He looks like Bobby, too,
Bobby from fucking
King of the Hill.
King of the Hill.
You got a little Bobby.
Now, hey there, Bobby.
Yeah.
Bobby?
Bobby? Okay. Yeah. So what's wrong with Jason Ellis?
Started having a conversation with him. I'm not blaming Sam at all, by the way. I mean, I'm just saying. I had a conversation with this guy.
Right.
And somehow it ended up him hating me, and we ended up having this back and forth where...
This must have been like when you met your dad.
Oh, don't bring up his dad.
No, that's all right.
Stevie, he didn't even know, Stevie.
I know, it's all right.
Dad hates him.
He scares very easily, and we finally learned why, because he got beat up a lot as a kid. His own father.
You're like when you get a rescue pet, and you can't pet it.
Yeah, he's kind of like that.
Okay.
Who hasn't been smacked by their father? Man up, your pussy.
I'm not.
I tell you what, my mother... This is how sadistic this bitch was,
Gunther.
Right? Yeah. She used to make me think when I did something wrong that I'd gotten away with it, right? And then would be punching you at 3 a.m, would wake you up to hits 5 or 6 hours later. She'd put an ass kicking in her diary. So, yeah, you didn't have it so bad.
That
come on.
Gary Shandling shit is annoying.
No, I don't want sympathy for it. I just,
Now, you fucking completely brushed over the whole thing. So we were talking, and then he hates me. What happened during the conversation? You had to have done something that pissed him off. If he comes in here
Tony
and tells
Curtis
us...
is dead.
Yeah, we know about that one.
We were talking. I noticed he had an Australian accent. I asked him, you're all from Australia. And, he's like has this attitude towards me. I don't even.
Well, then Stevie started making boomerang jokes.
Oh, okay. See, now why do you leave that shit out?
Yeah. Why would you do that?
Tell me the boomerang joke.
I don't even remember. It was like, he was gonna throw a boomerang at me or something. I was like,
that's a good one.
No, it was a joke.
What you should have done is he should have said a boomerang joke, then you should have said good comeback because it's a boomerang.
See, that's a boomerang joke. Now you see a professional as opposed to you.
And you
that's
do have Gary Shandling's lips. Now that I'm seeing the pictures online.
Oh, those Gary Shandling mouths.
Why don't we get Jason in here? Because we're not getting a proper story.
You know why?
No, keep him in.
Stop pushing him around. Stop pushing him around.
Jason Ellis, everyone.
Look at this animal. My God.
I didn't know we didn't go on the radio.
Jason's on Faction, Sirius 28 XM 52, Monday through Friday, 3 to 7. And then, of course, we do the best of Jason Ellis here on our fine channel. So what happened with you and Stevie to start
off? Look at little fucking Stevie over
there. Stevie. Oh, this motherfucker over here?
Yeah.
I saw him yesterday, and somebody said that he was kind of like my guy, that you mean they're a little bit fucked in the head or whatever, a little bit useless and shit.
Yeah.
And so I said something to him about his shoes or something, but he spracked off back to me. And then this morning he talked about, he called me a princess when I wasn't in the corridor, so he wasn't even fucking with anymore. It was like sort of a backstab thing in another corridor. So I was like, well, if you want to play again, because he said we're all working for the same company, he's an intern, and why would I hit him? Because he's smart. He pretends, he uses his stupid face. I've already got him. He's got a stupid face, and he uses that as an excuse. He's actually kind of smart with his fucking dumb-looking head. He's like, duh, I don't know what you mean, motherfucker. Like, he's talking shit. He knows. Yeah, so I want him to be in the game that
slander.
I brought today.
I take total offense to that.
I don't want sex bagel. Who's sex bagel?
Oh, no, that's E-Rock.
Who's sex bagel?
Why did you have to go with the sex bagel name?
I don't want
to
play a game with sex bagel.
It's E-Rock.
Your lips look like a horse's asshole right after it takes a shit. Like, that's what you do. It just looks like
a clinched fucking vagina. Yeah.
You know what I like about that is that you've seen enough horses, assholes,
oh,
after
yeah,
shit.
Oh, yeah, I grew
who
up
has it, man? What's wrong?
I grew up in Southern California. Very equestrian.
It looks like, yeah.
He's got burn victim lips.
Yeah, you really do.
Stevie, why did you call Jason Ellis
they
a princess?
They look like they used to be stuck to something.
Yeah. Why'd you call him a princess?
It was a casual. I was joking with one of the guys out there.
How is it casual to call someone a princess?
All I said was, the princess, because he was acting, I guess he's supposed to act like because he's a big star or whatever, but I mean, like...
A big star. See what I mean? Why was he acting like a princess? The last word that comes to my mind when I look at Jason Ellis is princess.
Yeah, no.
Can you imagine the ugly bitches he goes out with?
He's a virgin. He's a virgin.
He's another virgin.
Are you a virgin?
And you also... Yeah.
Why do you always intern virgins in this fucking place?
Because they get to do crazy things.
They're into fucking broadcasting.
They got low self-esteem.
Desperate for attention.
Just pay for it.
Yeah, they're all
he's got no money.
In.
He's a fucking intern.
Yeah.
And his father, left him a long time ago.
You get charged extra with that fucking crushed up pussy face, too. I'm telling you, hookers aren't going to do a $50 job on you. No way, right?
No.
Jason, watch out, though. Stevie has a tough punch.
If I was a hooker,
we all found out the hard
way. That would be my stomping ground.
Yeah.
You're right.
What's that, the hooker place?
Yeah, because he wouldn't know. He wouldn't fucking slap you around or anything. He'd just put it
in.
Your body's
a great fault.
And then he'd
probably not that big either, so he wouldn't hurt him.
No. You just cry.
You got a little dick there, dude?
You probably got a little dick.
How little is your dick, Stevie?
Can we see your dick, Steve?
No.
Hey, man, this makes you feel better. The average penis is 5 1/4. What do you got?
It is not.
I don't even know.
You don't know how big your penis is?
How big your penis is. How big their dick is.
Everyone's measured their
dick. Come on.
It's like, it's like 8 or 9. I don't know.
Oh, stop it. 8 or 9. No. When he said like, it looks like he's 8 or 9.
Yeah. Dude.
He doesn't know if it's 8 or 9.
8 or 9.
I love that. Could be 9. Could be 8. Depends on the day.
You got a 9-inch cock. You know you have a 9-inch.
Yeah. Hold on. I got $100. This is our first bit.
Yeah.
An easy 100.
I'll match it.
Anthony will match it. If you could fucking prove you got an 8 or 9-inch fucking penis,
I'll even give you a bet that it's under 5 1/2.
If it's near 8 inches, you don't have to be in the dog collar.
7.
Are we still allowed to measure cock on our show?
Start jacking.
Thumbs down to measuring cock on our show.
Intern cock.
What? No. Why
What's wrong with measuring
then,
intern
then
cock?
Fire him.
Can he do it in the bathroom?
Come on.
He can do
What's
it himself and then
can't
come
get
back.
Can he get sex bagel in the bathroom with him?
If the guy wants to fucking measure his cock, he should be allowed to measure his cock.
Seriously.
I didn't say I wanted to.
Do you want money?
Yeah. A couple hundred bucks.
Have you ever taken a photo of it and sent it to a girl?
You're not that desperate.
$200, you could get laid with that.
Well, yep. Why else is the intern here?
With your
nine-inch
cock.
My intern would measure his cock.
What you do is go home, measure it, and then take a photo, and then bring it back so we don't have to see it. Well, but you can cheat because you can get like one of those little Coke bottles off airplanes.
Is he allowed to take a picture in the bathroom of his cock?
Or a child's
hand? Yes, he is. Allegedly.
If he's lucky, a child's hand.
What about if he took it before he came here and it was in his phone? He just had to go retrieve it in the bathroom.
Take a picture of your dick in the bathroom.
Go on.
With your phone.
Yes, now, motherfucker.
With your phone.
Oh, does your phone take pictures? I remember you have like some old.
All right, I know what to do.
It's not that bad.
Hold on. Have him grab the Red Bull.
Yeah.
Yeah, beat that for $200.
Put your cock next to the Red Bull can.
How tall is a Red Bull can?
We'll measure that. But you got to.
It's not eight, I'll tell you that.
You've got to bat it off to get it erect. The Red Bull can's about 5 inches, I think.
Look, we could work around the rules, man.
At least get it alive. At least get it plump, and we'll be able to figure out.
Yeah.
Because if he's saying 9 inches. It's not even going to be fucking six.
Sure.
Yeah.
If it's plump, it's better than the Red Bull can.
You don't have to compete with girth of the Red Bull can.
No.
Leave that out of your mind.
We're not even worried about
just
your girth.
Just get the knob past the end of the can.
We do have a tape measure. Is he allowed to measure his own cock in the bathroom?
And we'll even...
Sooner the better, we'll be great.
All right, he can measure his own cock in the bathroom.
Okay.
What? He can't even measure his own cock in the bathroom?
I'm getting worried. Hang on.
Where do we measure? From the sack or from the top?
You can measure from his tailbone, and it still ain't going to be fucking 9 inches.
We can measure his cock.
We can.
All right, well, then fucking pull it down.
It can happen in the... He doesn't have to go into the bathroom. All it can happen here.
There you go. Face the fucking corner and start jacking it, asshole.
What happened here? You said 9 inches.
You got any porn or something? You got any porn?
Who's being the princess now? Who's being the princess now?
Hey, you want me to fucking touch your nipples while you're jacking it, asshole?
We've all whipped out.
Come on, I'm the princess. Maybe I can do a little dance for you. You can see it on my skirt.
Here it is, liar.
Here's mine.
Fucko.
Here's mine.
I got $100 for you.
And here's mine.
You did say
he'll never know. It's a dollar.
Can I borrow $100? I'll give it back to you tomorrow. I haven't got it on me.
You're coming in?
Yeah, I'm here tomorrow.
I got $100 too, shitbag.
Hey, shitbag, it's up to $400.
Hey, wait a minute.
No, it's up to $400 cash.
Because I know I'm not going to have to fucking
pay. Hey, I'm not really. It's not a huge claim for me. You got an 8-inch cock. You can have everything in my money clip.
Yeah, look at that. Because we know you're lying.
Now turn around, Stevie. We've all done that.
We've all done cockpits on the radio.
Think about it. If you really do beat this fucking Red Bull can, how many people are listening? You're going to get some MySpace. You're going to get a blowjob without paying for it. Chicks love big dicks.
And now we got porno in studio.
$400 and you can buy yourself a good hooker for $400.
There's some penthouses.
Not a great one, but a good one.
Either way, you're going to get laid.
Unless you want fucking Black Inches. You want that one?
What?
You want fucking
I had a purple cock the other day,
No, no.
If someone gives me a purple cock and balls.
Why?
I fucking crashed my dirt bike and got internal bleeding in my stomach, and then it went down, so this part was a white guy, and then just from the shaft on, all purple.
Wow.
Like a fucking bleeding cock, full sensitive testicles for like a month, like they hurt the touch and shit.
What the fuck?
I pulled my dick out and showed every single person I knew.
It was never.
That's what I'm saying.
It's in the rule book.
I would do it to you, and you go, no. Look, I don't want to see it. And then I would pull it out, and you'd go, fuck! Everybody, check out Alice's cock. Everybody did it. I did it on Hollywood Boulevard.
Of course.
To these dudes on Fuel that I kind of know on Fuel TV, they were like, "What's been going on?" First thing that came to my mind was I got a purple cock and balls, and there was a girl there, and I was like, "You got to see it." And they're kind of a little uptight.
How purple, though?
I've got a fucking photo, but it has a Twitter account. My purple cock follows me on Twitter.
Did I once show a
actually talk shit on me a couple of times the other day.
Did I once show a wart on my cock on this show?
You got warts on your cock?
Yeah, I've had a wart.
They don't go away, you know that,
No, it's 80% of all Americans got them. Yeah, I've got them for life.
That's what you're
telling yourself. I'm in the 20%.
I once got a cluster of warts on my fucking sphincter, right?
Oh my God, I'd rather have a fucking microscopic penis.
I went to the doctor. I bent over and I spread my... This is years and years ago. I spread my asshole open. The doctor's like, "Oh yeah." He goes, "You've been having anal sex?" I went, "No." And he's like,
"I want to."
He's like, "Are you sure?" And I'm like, "I'm pretty sure."
This is really gay, but you've got warts on your cock, but that is my fucking dick.
Oh!
It looks like a dead guy's dick, huh?
Oh!
It's a dead dick.
Oh, man.
Look at that.
Dude, were you afraid it was going to fall off?
No. No, I've got two kids, so I wouldn't mind if it did anyway. But it got a little bit worse than that.
What the
Thank
fuck?
You. Thank you. Anybody else want to see my purple car?
Did you tweet that picture?
Huh?
You tweet that one?
Are you jacking up in the car? Did I tweet it?
If it's a purple cock, you got to tweet that picture.
It's full on cock.
I like that it's purple and shaven.
I did a shaft one for my Twitter. That's just the shaft. I have my hand over it.
Ah. Jesus.
I probably should have done that, but.
What happened to the crazy?
Jesus Christ. What happened to the cluster of warts around your asshole, Jim?
This is what happened, right? So the doctor goes, he goes, oh, you must have been having anal sex. I'm going, I really haven't. he sends me off to the sexual clinic type of thing, right? And so this doctor bends me over, this real old doctor, and I bend over and I go, I haven't been having anal sex. He goes, oh, no, it's all connected. He goes, you probably just was fucking wiping your ass and there's germs there and you've got some warts there. He goes, it's not a big deal. Come back in next week and we'll burn them off. Right? So for about a week, I'm just wiping around my cluster of warts, feeling horrible. Fuck. I go back there, I bend over, I pull my ass open, I can smell the steam coming off the burning gun.
That's got to be bad.
And then he goes, the exact words, he goes, oh, they've fallen off. Well, you're okay then. And I put my pants back on, and it's the only time I've ever believed in God. I was like, this is all right, so I didn't have my ass burnt. But I haven't had one since.
It was a miracle.
Is that what it looked like? We're looking at a picture of a cluster of warts.
Jesus, what's wrong with you, Jim?
No, mine was like two little ones.
No, he said a cluster. That's a cluster.
No,
two's not a cluster.
No.
Five's a cluster.
It fell off. It was in a little bunch. Uh-huh. It was maybe that big. It was hanging off like an ass tag. And it fell off.
I can't take it.
You gotta look.
Nobody put a dick near your ass.
No one put a dick near my ass. I'd put things
look
up my
in,
ass.
Look him in his own. Eyes and say that.
Wow.
No one put a dick in my ass.
Oh, well, that makes it. Yeah, I believe it. <Sure. laughs> You're a fucking comedian. You know you can trust.
Are you guys getting along?
Yeah.
Why is he fucking
you hate me.
Standing there?
Well, I don't. You weren't very nice to me last time. No,
you weren't nice to me.
What do you measure?
After I got off the air.
You weren't nice to me on the air.
I didn't say anything mean to you on the air, did I?
Yes, you did.
What did I say?
Yeah, no pulling.
What did I say?
No stretching.
At the beginning.
What did I say?
You were saying, I can't remember the exact words, but you pissed me off at the beginning.
Fair enough. I can be annoying.
Yeah. All right, we're cool. All right.
Where are you from?
Sydney.
Yeah, well, you'll be all right.
See, this is the thing, right, about Australians.
I fucking live in LA. I give a fuck about any of you.
I live in LA as well. I live in LA. But where are you?
We had to move here to make it, didn't we?
Oh, no, I'd already made it in other countries.
Have you?
Yeah. No, I'm more popular in the UK.
You kind of do sound English. You go there a little bit.
I lived there for 10 years.
Oh, there it is.
Yeah. Hang on. I think he's measuring.
Wow, they get along now. That's good. Jim, now you got to do Jason's show. He broadcasts from L.A.
Yes. Fine.
I'm serious.
Well, he seems really pumped about it.
Well, I got to, you know.
Don't make a measure from his fucking nutsack.
Sam, what's going on over there?
One of the things being standoffish is a guy measuring
his Stevie's putting the tape measure way deep into his pants.
But is it hard
now?
Is it hard?
It's not.
Of course it's
not
the shaft.
I can tell you it's not more than 4 inches because I'm sitting on an angle where if it was 9, I could already see it from here.
And it'd be hanging out everywhere.
Yes.
You'd fucking pull it out and just stick it past the can.
Is his pants down a little bit?
I'd be swinging around like a fucking zoot suit.
If someone gives me a glove, I will massage it with my hand.
Use your fucking t-shirt.
No, I love this t-shirt.
Use the other one. Has anyone got a tissue?
Yeah, Stevie, what's up?
I'm very self-conscious right now, so... Well,
if you had a 9-inch dick, you wouldn't be fucking...
No, exactly, you'd be whipping that shit out.
I'd walking down the hall with it hanging out. Stopwatch. You know what I mean? What time is it? Hey, everybody, look what time it is. It's fucking 9 o'clock, motherfucker.
It's not even...
What are you doing tonight?
It's not even poking outside the jeans yet.
Oh. Like, it's looking like it's got a spine.
Sam, make sure... Whip it out?
Show us
the dick. We don't give a shit, Steve.
Whatever you need to do.
Turn around and pull it out. Fucking have a good old day with your bullshit. Oh, rubber gloves. Wait a minute.
Hold on, we got rubber gloves. Hold on, we got rubber gloves.
Do you want to hold the back of your elbow and we'll do that rowboat thing so it's not gay?
I'm putting the glove on for his benefit.
Jim Jeffries, you better, it will be the official measurer.
All right.
Put those gloves on. This is very clinical, Stevie.
Is your Red Bull can, champ?
It's just measuring.
Yeah, this is just measuring.
I'm going to hold the can
Nothing's
next
being
to
No problem.
We're looking
Nothing's
forward to
being
it.
Now, at least show Jeffries.
No, I don't have it out.
Pull your fucking dick out.
All right, Jeffries.
I'm looking at, I can see
Jeffries
his face.
Got a blue glove on. He's holding a Red Bull can.
Hold on.
Oh, come on!
looks like everyone can take their hundreds back.
I'm going to take my hundreds back.
What happened?
I didn't even know why you would pull it out if it was that small.
Jim, it literally didn't make the barcode.
it's not as big as the barcode on the fucking can.
Stevie, why would you lie?
Stevie, what are you doing, Stevie?
If you're going to lie, you say six or seven. People aren't going to fucking call you on it.
It was soft.
It's a grower, not a show.
I'm a grower, not a show as well, but mine's not 9 inches. Mine looks slightly bigger than that, and I get to maybe six at best, right? Now, you're lying.
Yeah. Which you've done before.
What you did there was a lie.
You were caught lying.
You're not supposed to pull it out when you say that.
If you're going to lie, say seven. Say seven and a half.
Not even.
You don't go 8, 10, 11.
Or 9. Like,
yeah, you're going into the monster category.
It literally...
You can't even use 9 correctly.
It was the barcode.
It was the barcode on the Red Bull can.
So you're talking an inch and a half.
I'm talking 12 numbers.
A nose.
in a small font.
A large man's nose.
That's an inch. Your dick was an inch and a half long.
Yeah, because it's not even...
Oh my God!
Your cock wasn't big enough for the nutritional facts.
1 inch of rock-hard boner over here.
It's hard on, that's not even two inches.
It's great to be on the show, I tell you.
I've got pictures of my own cock on my phone as well. And that's the modern technology, that's what it's done. Is people are more slutty and sleazy now. Because I can get drunk and I go to some send me a picture of your finger up your ass. And they'll send it. But eventually if you do enough of that, you'll get a girl who'll go, send you a picture of your cock. So I've got on my phone, I've got maybe 4 different pictures of my cock in different moods.
You got a wart snap?
No, I've only got ones on good angles. I haven't had a wart
for a
while.
You're
hiding the wart? I feel like if I got warts in my ass, I'd take a photo of it.
No, well, why didn't you take a photo of that? That was about 8 years ago, the warts in the ass.
Yeah, they had cameras then.
Not in your camera, not on your phone, though.
You got to take a
picture. Not digital. I was still on film 8 years ago.
Old school.
Yeah,
but you were in England.
You couldn't go down to the fucking place going, yeah, there's a few holiday snaps here who I'm a bit sensitive about. When are you back at work?
Forgot about that.
Because that's what it is. Because remember that used to be the one picture of, like, you'd have your girlfriend sunbaking topless in Spain or something, and that would be the one. Now you've got like all the horrible. It's like so. Girls now get me to send a picture of my cock to them, and I'm drunk, and I just go cock's end, right?
Yeah, of course.
Where in the old days you'd be like up in like a black room with the water,
developing your cock developing, photo,
thinking.
Then you got to walk down to the fucking post office.
When the post office opens, that slut's gonna get it.
That's right.
Yeah,
in 3 days she's gonna get it.
She's
boy.
Gonna fucking get it. That slut.
Or later on, like back in the mid '90s, you were able to fax a picture, but there is no detail in a faxing of your cock.
But that's what used to be so exciting about someone photocopying their ass.
Yeah.
You can't see inside the hole.
No, it just turned out as a...
Yeah, set against a smush.
Had no dimension to it at all.
And dimension is really where it's at.
That is.
I'll give you the benefit of the doubt if you get it hard, because you look really sad now.
I don't want to get hard. I'm very conscious.
All right, you might as well get hard, Stevie.
That's his look.
How about if I give you the picture of my cock to help you get hard? Because I think that might do it.
No, I'm not like that.
You got a lot to prove now. You might as well get hard.
You were looking at a picture of that woman, that beautiful woman.
He's saying it now.
Hold on.
Stevie is saying to Sam that Ellis is a douchebag.
What?
Not a half hour ago. A mere minute or two ago.
What happened?
Is it true, Sam?
Well, yeah, he was like kind of shaking his head going like this, and I said, good job. And then he whispered, Jason Ellis is a douchebag.
Why the fuck would you say that?
What did I have to do with that?
What is your problem?
That was fucking Jim telling you. He's put the coke, he put the can next to your dick. Yeah,
I was probably more a douchebag in that situation.
What's wrong with you?
Jason Ellis isn't responsible for your inch and a half long fucking puny dick.
He is blind, so when Jeffries was talking, he might have thought it was Jason Ellis. So
we do have a similar physique.
No.
Do you know who was looking at your dick?
Laugh so hard.
Yes. You know I haven't looked at your dick, right?
Yeah, I know.
Why is he a douchebag now?
I tell you, I'm always surprised about the guests who are on this show who haven't had sex, who have gnarly look, dog bitten up cocks. Like Bobo's cock's horrific looking.
Oh, that thing has been through the fucking mill. Yeah,
I'll tell you, you got a better cock than Bobo.
The better cock than Bobo.
Nice. We'll give you that.
What about form and shape? Normal.
Better than Bobo's and every. I know it looked a little bit
Sad.
It was a little bit sad. I have to see it erect because everyone's flaccid cock isn't a work of art.
It looked sad. There's so many different sides to a flaccid cock.
Tell you what, it looks straight. It looked like you had a straight one. There was no kink in it.
Okay.
You don't have a bend.
How's his balls?
No, I didn't get to see his balls. He just poked it out.
All right, you better pull your pants down. We got to look at the balls now.
I think he's got hairy
balls. And we
got
to check for a cluster of warts.
Just give us some fly's eyes. Just throw one ball out.
But wait a minute. You're a virgin. There's no way you have anything on there, right? Yeah. You have no sexually transmitted disease. You haven't had sex.
No.
You're in the clear. Yeah. Anybody in here never had a sexually transmitted disease?
I've only got the PVD or whatever.
Did you fucking ask?
I'm not going to say anything, but
that's pretty gnarly.
80%
of people have ass warts.
That's not
true.
Have the gene? HPV gene or whatever it is.
Yeah, but how many people have warts in their ass?
I only had it the once.
Yeah, but you're saying 80% of the people have
enough.
80% of the people have that gene.
Has anyone had ass warts once?
No.
Me neither.
I've never had one on my finger.
I think to get an actual statistic, you need to ask more than three people.
Statistic people, there's no way it's 80%.
Also,
It's not 50. It's not 50-50. No, you're in a fucking 10% class of ass warts.
80% of people have the gene that could lead to ass warts.
Yeah, but why are they in the ass? Why do they grow in your ass?
I was doing things with my ass.
What?
Do you really put stuff in there?
Jason's done
some crazy shit in his day.
I had suction from a black tranny.
Back in the day, I used to put.
Did you have suction from a black tranny?
No, I've never.
In your face,
I've never slept with a transvestite. No, nor would I.
I didn't sleep with her. I had suction. Yeah. I wasn't making out with her. I was fucking 17. I cried afterwards, motherfucker. It's fucking ass rape in Amsterdam.
It's not the transsexual thing. It's the black thing. I'm not into.
Yeah, actually.
Oh, yeah, well, God gave you ass warts, you racist cunt.
That's hilarious.
No, I did. You didn't know it was a tranny? Was it?
No, I went and got a hooker in Amsterdam. I used to get a lot of, I would just go from one to the other, and it was a black one, and I think maybe I'd slept with only one other black girl before, and I was like, oh, cool. And then I went in there and gave her the money, and then she sort of turned me around and was jacking me off, and I was like, what? And then I'm like, oh, she's trying to finger me in the ass, and I'm like, I don't think that I'm going to be into that, and then it was like trying to get in my ass, and I was like, ah, like, I didn't agree to it, and I turned around, and it was a dick.
Oh my God.
There was a little dick. It was like a 4-inch black dick that she was trying to put in my ass, and I was like, oh, no, I can't, it's okay, I just gotta go, and I just left, and all my friends were there, like, hey, Alice, and I'm like, yeah, you know Alice. Hell, you know how many fucking the bitches in Amsterdam? And then I went and drank some beers.
And then cried.
I went back to, I lived in Canada. I went back to Canada and told my girlfriend that I cheated on her with a hooker that tried to fuck me in the ass with her black dick. And when I explained the story, the emotions of actually knowing that a dick was forced into my ass. Because I had suction. It didn't go in. It went in enough for me to go, I don't like ass play.
So it got right up against the sphincter.
Yeah.
Like it didn't actually, did it, there was, no, a, was there a pucker a, up?
Suction. Okay, suction.
Yeah, there's enough, so to, there was enough to bother you.
So, yeah, they could say, you could say I've been fucking the ass by a black man.
It started opening up a little bit.
It started to open accept. Up a little.
To accept.
Yeah.
Wow.
And I cried.
And he didn't get the wart clusters.
No warts. I'd rather a black dick than ass warts.
He's gay. Look at that. He had gay sex.
Who?
That counts as gay.
I've had more sex.
I tell you what, you may have a small dick, but you got huge balls on.
What is wrong with you? You know what Jason can do to you?
I would never do anything to this guy. Except I do have a kendo stick if you want to test that out.
Yeah. No, look, here's what happened. I tried to be a nice guy, Hugh, and for no reason, you just started, stepping on me.
That's fucking bullshit, dude. I don't even know you. Look at your fucking stupid face. I'm trying to fucking be nice to you because you look like a stupid prick. And I fucking say, hey, man, how's it going? Oh, fucking blah, blah, tough guy over here. Like, what, do I look like a tough guy to you, motherfucker? Am I in your
I'm
face?
I'm kidding.
I was saying hello to you because you like worked for Opie and Anthony.
That's not what I started with.
Then I said some shit about your fucking shoe because you don't take care of yourself. How can you be such a baby and so fat?
Hey, you don't know anything about life.
Eat a fucking salad, for fuck's sake. Take a bottle of water in there.
He starts off having a conversation with me with backhanded compliments.
You started
with a backhanded compliment?
No, that's not what he said.
That's a spinning back fist compliment.
And then he thinks I'm a retard, so he thinks I'm not gonna notice what he's saying. No, he thinks that I'm an idiot.
You're a fucking witty guy with your stupid face, and you started to flick back, so I was like, alright, fuck you, see you in hell tomorrow. So here we are at the dog collar challenge, motherfucker.
What's the dog collar challenge?
Why do you gotta be like that? I was just trying to, you know, have a connection with you, and you gotta be a douche.
Fucking liar. Oh, you did, man, not want to connect, Stevie, with me. You don't want to bond with me, you fucking asshole. You gotta weird about it.
That's what guys do. They joke around.
That's, you, yep. Nah, man, you started, and I joked back. I'm not really going to hit anybody. I'm just fucking with you.
You're very
I was fucking with you very friendly, like, yesterday. I didn't say anything too bad.
Maybe it's friendly in Australia, but, you know,
I live in America.
Oh,
I say you're racist, but you're not a race.
Nazi? Holy shit, this guy.
A Nazi?
Yeah, you were racist to some black guy yesterday, too.
What? No.
What was that about?
Dude, spracking off to some black guy, calling him, I don't know what he was calling him, right after he got in my face. And I'm like, fuck this stupid face, little bitch.
Who's Stanley T?
What did you say about Stanley T?
Nothing. I was talking
about accept racism in this studio.
I was calling him. I was calling because he's a Phillies fan, so I was talking about the Phillies. And I was talking about Ryan Howard. And next thing you know, oh, wow, I'm a racist because, you know.
You said they all look alike, right? Yes. He said that.
That's not what I
said.
Said
you all look alike, Opie.
Oh, that's good.
Wow. Yeah. Do you just blurt stupid shit out? But
no.
Were you sure that was the black guy you were speaking to? Because I get confused.
He's being very, very backhanded towards me. And he's just being very confrontational. And I don't appreciate it.
Which one's that? The black guy that all looks alike or me? Yeah.
No, you.
Yeah. I was doing that.
Yeah.
Stevie, show Jason Ellis your moves. They're pretty terrific.
No, I don't.
Remember
wanna,
when you went after
see,
Sam?
I don't want to fight.
We were all really scared.
Yeah, no,
Sam,
fight.
Would you allow him to spar with you?
He doesn't want to hurt somebody.
Watch this. Watch this, Jason. This Sam, is what you're gonna. This right? is what you're gonna deal with.
Like he's gonna snap.
Oh, no, hang on.
This is what you're gonna deal with.
You might want to take it easy.
This is what you're gonna deal with. Sam is poking, pushing.
Hang on. This is the reason people show up to work with a gun and shoot everyone.
Oh my God! What the hell was
that?
That
was an unbelievable.
This looks like a retard schoolyard fight.
Stop.
See.
Oh shit! He's punching Sam now. Holy shit!
Oh my God!
He just punched Sam in the face.
Oh my God!
He just belted Sam in the side of the
head. That looked like two retards fighting over a retainer.
Wow!
What happened there, Sam?
Stevie's got moves.
Sam, you all right?
Yeah, I'm fine. I mean, that's what happens when you spar with a warrior.
Next time.
What are you talking him up you like a wrestler?
You look a little bit shocked there, though. He hit you in the face.
He punched me in the back of the neck, in the forehead. He's just a tough guy.
Let me see.
Your forehead's
your
a bit red right now.
Yeah. He got you. He nailed you.
He got you pretty good.
Did he
good.
Get you in the cheek there as well? No.
Back of the neck punch.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
It's a back of the neck.
Now's
punch.
The time if you clock him right now.
See, I'm sorry, but you know.
That was like fucking.
Hey, yeah. No, you know,
that
yeah,
was
yeah,
like
yeah.
MMA, Mongoloid martial arts.
Oh, man.